Good afternoon again, gentlemen. Are you happy?
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, my old mother told me something that I've remembered all my life. He says, don't trust people who wear dinner suits in the daytime. And that includes head waiters and cinema managers. Not to be trusted. So, how many are we? About 12 or 13. 12 or 13 boiled shirts. With Ricketts Blue. Do you remember Ricketts Blue? I still drink it. Now, this is a tribute to Fred Elizalde. Now, he was the band leader who came in. He'd been in America playing in California. He came over, he was invited over to bring his band, very modern band for his day, to the Savoy. There was the Savoy Havana band and other Savoy bands, but when Elizalde came in, he brought some American friends. Many of them were from New England, from Boston, etc. And the great players, including the great Adrian Rollini on the bass saxophone. Stand up, Adrian Rollini. Now, the idea of a tribute to Fred Elizalde was the idea of Franz Justrum, wonderful bass saxophone player who's been at the festival for quite a few years. Unfortunately, Franz couldn't be with us this year, and what we did, Claus, myself, and Michael McQuaid, we said we would bring and do the Fred Elizalde thing that Franz always wanted, and we've arranged. He did some arrangements, Michael done some, I've done some. So for France, I'm sorry you're not here, France, but we're at least doing it for you. Ladies and gentlemen, the first one is called Stomp Your Feet, and I want everybody on the floor, on the carpet, and it's a real Charleston, all right?
Thank you.
to say, Elizalde played for the dancers, and you, in those days, in the ballrooms, they used to say that if you can't hear the shuffling of the dancers' feet that's in the band, you're playing too loud. And that was the rule for dancing. Now, handing you over to the next arranger, Mr. McQuaid, will explain about the next piece.
The next tune we're going to play is called Clarinet Marmalade, and this one was recorded by the Elizalde band twice prior to their American friends coming and joining. And this particular arrangement is notably good taste. Clarinet Marmalade, Marmalade. Good taste, because there's no clarinet at all.
Finished like that, and the audience still carried on dancing. Mike Davis, stand up, Mike. A great exponent of the trumpet styles, almost before Big Spiderwick, wasn't it? Could you just demonstrate a little bit of the vodeo, vododo?
Most of these are Chelsea Quayle on them, and whether they are or not, I've gotten into the Chelsea Quayle mindset, and he plays a lot of...
I'm speechless. Nothing like that has been heard in Newcastle since 1924. Mike Davis. I'm afraid Herr Jacobi is stuck behind the bass saxophone. So this is the smaller group, and it's called the Darkstown Stratus Ball. Who played in the smaller group then?
Well, that's just Chelsea Quealy and Bobby Davis and Rolini.
And Rolini.
And the whole group.
Nobody from the James Last Orchestra.
No.
The Darktown Stratus Ball, which was a few years older, you know, it was an out of date composition, but they did a lovely job. All yours.
All right.
2015, there was a very rare film of the Fred Elizalde band that's not released anywhere, but it's held by the British Film Institute. I made an appointment, and I paid, I don't know, something like £30 to go and spend a time viewing this particular film. I had to sign things saying I wouldn't copy it and all sorts of things. I watched the film. It's a dance lesson, and the sugar step is the dance that they're learning. Unfortunately, the instructor is terrible, which is probably why the film was never released. However, the band sounds wonderful, and there's a wonderful Chelsea Quealy solo, which I, while I was there, wrote down, and you're going to hear that, played by Mike Davis. So this is the most obscure thing you could possibly imagine, except for something that I've written down that never was played at all. So this is the sugar step. One, two, three, four. £30 to listen and write that out, I'll be collecting a pound each. Recoup that expense. The next one we'd like to play is one called Arkansas, and this is an arrangement that actually came from the California Ramblers, or rather a smaller group within that, the Group of Five. And this is one of the arrangements that Adrian Rollini brought over to the Elizalde band with him when he came from America. And it's a nice little small group thing, Arkansas.
Yeah.
Group of Five.
Tune's been arranged by Claus, or transcribed by Claus, and it's a piece written originally by Adrian Rollini, bass saxophone feature, Dixie. It's not that one. Dixie was the name of Adrian Rollini's wife. So there we are. So. Thank you.
sir.
After a while, you know, it wasn't the small band really playing for the dancers. They had at least a 10-piece group, and later on it was so popular that they augmented with a couple of violins and vocalists, and it was quite a large band. The only trouble with Fred Elizalde that he was very modern inclined, and he used to write very futuristic tunes, and eventually the audiences at the at the Savoy that was used to what we call bog standard ballroom, they thought, we can't pick out any melodies, you know, there's no songs that we know, you see. So they were given warnings, and Fred did some more futuristic stuff, and in the end they were released to do variety theatres, you see. Can you imagine them? They probably came up here. To play futuristic tunes to you. But anyway, this is the larger band, and it's it features the silver mask tenor singing, Mr. Jacobi, my pet, beloved by Big Spider-Man. You're not here to enjoy yourself now. Come on, play.
Thank you.
what I did to that keyboardist. Here we go. Mr. Jacobi, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to do a Noel Coward number to entertain you. It's one recorded by Fred Elizalde, but this is a slightly different arrangement, not the one that's on the record. And we have a perfect singer to sing Noel Coward for you. It is, of course, Thomas Spatzlener. You've got his jacket on. You better miss me, darling.
I miss you already. This smoking jacket, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon, by the way. It's of great significance to the British jazz scene because it was worn originally by Alan Cooper, I think. Now, just before he passed away, he gave me this jacket and he said, "Dear boy, I think you should wear this for when you go and do that fancy stuff with young Nichols." And I said, "Well, I know occasionally I have to do this." So anyway, he lent it me. And the first thing that happened was is that the dry cleaners wouldn't dry clean it because they said it would fall apart. And the second thing I found three elastic bands in this pocket and a dog biscuit. Half a pack of silk cut cigarettes in this half. And I've still somewhere got the Alan Cooper match. There you go, it's still in there. So.
We're using it again.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dance Little Lady.
There's not really any
well,
room.
That's mine.
No.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Yes. Oh, well, you can knock it off. It only belongs to Claus.
Are we ready?
1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
Thank you.
give you one more rendition. And in order to be able to play a tune of an oriental persuasion, we do have my old mate and buddy, the gong player extraordinaire. What's your name? Abraham Himmelbrand. The real name of Teddy Brown. And of course, Josh will be playing the gong. Now, this arrangement is called it's Singapore Sorrows, which is a disguised version of the Limehouse Blues, written by, the arrangement was written by Fud Livingston, great arranger, for the Ben Pollock Orchestra. Later on, Fud himself came to England to join the Elizalde band in the Savoy and brought the arrangement with him. So this is recrafted for Fred Elizalde. Can you just tune up the gong, please? Miles. By the way, we have a splendid violinist, Miss Emma Fisk. Chris Compton, the trombone. Mike Davis. Miles Frank. Michael McQuaid. Richard Exel. There's Abe playing the part of Adrian Leaney, as members of the BBC Drama Repertory Company, Klaus Jacobi. Martin Wheatley, Vanguard. Philip Rutherford. And the Vanguard percussion kit, Nick Ball. And of course, the lovely Spats. So now, okay, everybody on the floor for Singapore Sorrows. Thank you. Thank you.